We used our vacation to try out how it would feel like to work on First of Us Function full time. Spoiler, it was awesome! We will discuss what this means for our future at the end of the video. But first, First of Us Function is a fast-paced action roguelike with hard-hitting spells and lots of dodging. Here's a quick overview of what we did in these 2 weeks of full-time work.
We added a context-sensitive tutorial that does not force the player to read more than 5 words at a time.
We now have a Steam page where you can wishlist First of Us Function. The link is in the description.
We added score. It even changes color based on where you get the score from.
We added potions, because it turns out recovering HP is kind of important.
We fixed a few bugs that annoyed us for months. Casting is more reliable now. Telegraphs don't stay on board randomly, and debuffs now fade with the enemies they are on.
Tons and tons of visual polish, including transitions, varying background colors, a very flexible system for screen shake that may be over-engineered but is awesome, new telegraph colors that look better and don't kill your graphics card, new pixel blood that is bloodier and more pixelated, and much, much more.
We redesigned and rewrote the casting system once again.
Enemies can now be interrupted. We redesigned all their behaviors and rewrote a lot of old code.
We worked on the corrupted forest board. It started to look sufficiently disgusting.
We talked to Fabru, who is interested in making music for us. He already made this track for the spaceboard.
It is a shame that we cannot talk about all those things in detail, but you can get extra updates on Twitter if you want. Remember the bumpers? They are gone. And it's gone. It was fun while it lasted, and they will come back as stage hazards at some point. We replaced them with nothing. We playtested a lot and found players tend to look at the telegraphs exclusively. So we made them our main indicator. We gave the buttons a unique color scheme and let them flash when they are ready. Vector spells get an additional unique indicator. The game suddenly is really low UI, and we like it that way. The dash got the same treatment. We show it, if it is ready, using the player outline telegraph.
For the next mechanic, we let ourselves inspire by nature. Have you ever noticed that whenever someone is doing a complex task, you can usually make them stop by beating them real hard? We captured this dynamic with the interrupt system. Each cast has an amount of armor. Armored enemies take no damage and reduced knockback. This makes them pretty scary. But once the armor is broken with this really juicy animation, they take a ton of damage, knockback, and stop their cast. It makes combat much more interactive.
The enemy movesets were previously always the same in each round. This was kind of blah. We found that for this game, RNGesus is our one and only savior. Honestly, since everything is so explicitly communicated, we can get away with metric poopy tons of RNG. Enemies know random when they cast, what they cast, how many spells, and even which angle is used.
Also, we continued a tradition. We reworked our casting system again, but it seems to fall into place. Remember the auto hit? It's gone. The direction was right, but we found a better way. We merged it with the right spell. So now we have a spammable spell for the right button. A dash once per round that you can refresh by killing stuff on space, and a really, really mighty late game spell once per round on the left button. The main purpose of the auto hit was that players don't feel as helpless in the game as they feel in real life, which the spammable spell also solves. This also allows us to fling a huge amount of fireballs, which is what games are all about. Getting a working spell system just is stupidly hard work.
Also, implementing all this stuff is just so complicated. Really, why is it so complicated? Our old spell system was coded kind of okay, but for complicated stuff, kind of okay, code still is pain to work with. So we needed to bump it up to kinda good, which meant we rewrote it. We ripped spellcasting out of the player character controller completely, in a separate object entirely. The player script is now happy because it is a little less bloated and we can instantiate as many spellcasters as we want. We don't really plan to do this, but maybe a mode with more than 2 spells might be fun. We did a lot of code improvements that were neither fun to do nor are they fun to talk about, but they are fun to have and now we have them. Maybe the most important thing we added are tutorials. Turns out it would cost quite a bit of time to explain each player how to play, so it needed to be a part of the game. It was most important to us to explain concepts with a low amount of words. I am not a fan of reading stuff on screen. It just breaks the flow. So we tried to stay below 6 words at any time. This is not a lot of words. We tried to reach this by only explaining what a player absolutely needs to know at this point in time. We only talk about the spells the player actually has. The game has a ton of depth, but honestly, for the first few hours, it is fine just to throw colorful spells at colorful bad guys. There are so many more topics to talk about, but honestly, we need to be really efficient with our time use. YouTube costs a lot of time, making game costs a lot of time, and full-time work costs a huge amount of time.
We love making games and would love to do it all day long. But we also love having money to pay the rent and buy some ramen. And we are not ready to take the risk and go full-time. Yet. But we strongly think about going part-time on our jobs at the end of this year and invest the rest into First of Us Fungeon and this channel. This still is so spooky. This wasn't even on our minds a year ago. And you, right there, sitting in front of the screen, you can help us. You can help this channel grow. Start by liking and sharing our videos. If people care about this game, it helps. Wishlist First of Us Fungeon on Steam. Play our demo when it is finally out. Bonus points if you do it on YouTube. When we open up a way to support us financially, consider throwing us some money. Would any of you guys be interested in supporting us on Patreon, Kickstarter, even buying First of Us merch? If so, let us know in the comments. Thank you guys for following the development of First of Us Fungeon. You have been the coolest watchers who have ever watched anything in the history of watching. We will now go and polish that thing until there is a demo.